myself Bavita, and today I'm giving the presentation on the topic amplitude modulation representation. So first of all, we have to know the definition of modulation. So here the definition of modulation is: in the modulation process, some characteristics of a high frequency carrier signal is changed according to the instantaneous amplitude of the information signal, which means that in modulation process, some characteristic of a carrier signal is changed due to the instantaneous amplitude of the information signals. And here, why modulation is used? Modulation is used because it is suitable for signal transmission, that is distance, etc., and multiple signals transmitted on the same channel. And number third, capacitive or inductive devices require high frequency AC input carrier to operate. And number fourth, it is stable and noise rejection, which means it rejects the noise. Therefore, we use the modulation. And here, another definition of modulation, which is defined as: it is the systematic alternation or changing of one waveform, that is low frequency carrier wave, according to the characteristic of another waveform, that is low frequency message signal. This is the another definition of modulation. And next, we have the goal of modulation. So the goal of modulation is to produce an information varying modulated wave whose properties are best suited for efficient utilization of communication channel. And here some applications and examples of amplitude modulation. So first one is broadcasting of both audio and video signals are the example of amplitude modulation. And the second one is mobile radio communication, such as cell phone, is the application of amplitude modulation. And here the basic modulation types. Basically, modulation is of three types. Number one is amplitude modulation, which changes the amplitude. Number two is frequency modulation, which changes the frequency. And number three is phase modulation, which changes the phase. Mainly we have three types. And here, this is the, as we know that a sine wave is represented as follows. C of t is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus phi of t. Here AC, FC and phi of t all represent parameters that can be modulated in carrier waveform in order to carry information. The modulation schemes are known as: in the above equation, CT is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus phi of t. AC is known as amplitude modulation, FC is known as frequency modulation, and phi of t is known as phase modulation. And here this is the flow chart of different types of modulation. So modulation is basically of two type, analog and digital modulation. And analog is also of two type, that is linear modulation and non-linear modulation. And next, linear modulation has only one part, that is amplitude modulation. And non-linear modulation is of two type, that is frequency modulation and phase modulation. As we can say that modulation is mainly of three types, that is amplitude modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation. So here the another point of modulation or benefit of modulation is: modulation can shift the spectral content of a message signal. जो spectral content होता है किसी message signal का, उसको जो है ये shift कर सकती है modulation into a band. Band में shift कर सकती है, convert कर सकती है, which is better suited to the channel. Antennas only efficiently radiate and admit signal whose wavelength is similar to their physical aperture, and hence to transmit and receive, say, voice by radio, we need to shift the voice signal to a much higher frequency band. And here we have the next point of modulation, that is modulation permits the use of multiplexing. Modulation permit karti hai use of multiplexing. So we have to know that what is the multiplexing. So definition of multiplexing is: multiplexing means allowing simultaneously communication by multiple users on the same channel, which means that ek channel ke upar multiple users jo hain wo allow karna is called multiplexing, matlab jo allow hote hain simultaneously. And number two is, for instance, the radio frequency spectrum must be shared, and modulation allows users to separate themselves into bands. And here we want to explain what is amplitude modulation. So the basic definition of amplitude modulation is, in amplitude modulation, the message signal MT is impressed on the amplitude of the carrier signal CT, which is equal to the AC cos 2 pi FCT. Here message signal is denoted by MT and carrier signal is denoted by CT, which is equal to the AC cos 2 pi FCT, which means that in amplitude modulation, the message signal is impressed on the amplitude of the carrier signal. And the next is, this results in a sinusoidal signal whose amplitude is a function of the message signal MT. There are several different ways of modulating the carrier signal by MT. Each results in different spectral characteristics for the transmitter signals. So mainly these methods are used for amplitude modulation. Four methods are used for amplitude modulation, and these four are: number one, double sideband with large carrier AM, which means DSB LC AM, and number two is double sideband suppressed carrier AM, which means DSB SC AM, number three is single sideband AM SSB AM, and number four is vestigial sideband VSB modulation. So here in this figure, the first one is modulating signal, the second one is carrier frequency, and the third signal is modulated signal. And here there is a multiplier oscillator. And in this figure, it is concluded that the bandwidth of the amplitude modulation is equals to the twice of bandwidth. And in this figure, there is modulating signal, which is denoted by Vm of t, carrier wave, which is denoted by Bc cos omega ct, and modulated signal, which is denoted by Vam of t equal to Vc plus Vm cos omega mt and cos omega ct, which means that both modulating signal and carrier wave signal produce the modulated signal. And here we have the amplitude modulation. Output envelope is a complex wave made up of, output envelope jo hai is a complex which is made up of DC voltage, carrier frequency, number 3 is sum frequency, which is FC plus FM, difference frequency, which is FC minus FM. So there is a diagram in which there is a carrier which is denoted by FC, and lower sideband and upper sideband, lower side frequencies and upper side frequencies. Here the lower sideband or lower side frequencies are denoted as FC minus F max, and upper sideband or upper side frequencies are denoted as FC plus F max. Upper sideband is denoted by FC plus F max. So from this figure we conclude that frequency spectrum of an amplitude modulation wave bandwidth is equal to 2fm of max. And we have the next is amplitude modulation. So band of frequencies between FC minus FM X and FC is lower sideband, and band of frequencies between FC plus FM X and FC is called upper sideband in amplitude modulation. Here is the percentage modulation and modulation coefficient. Here we have to describe about the percentage modulation, and this is also called modulation coefficient. So the definition of modulation coefficient or coefficient of modulation is a term used to describe the amount of amplitude change. This describes the amount of amplitude change. So percentage modulation is simply the coefficient of modulation stated as a percentage. So we have some mathematical equations that are M is equal to Em over Ec, which is equal to modulation coefficient. It is unitless. So we have modulation coefficient is equal to M is equal to Em over Ec. And the next one is equal to Em is equal to MEc from this figure. From our equation, if we have to find Em, then Em is equal to MEc, and Em is equal to peak change in amplitude of output volts, unit hertz ke. And the next is EC is equal to EM over M. From first equation, we also find the EC, then it is equal to EM over M. And EC is equal to peak amplitude of the unmodulated carrier voltage. There are three things, that is amplitude coefficient, which is denoted by M, peak change in amplitude of output, which is denoted by EM, and peak amplitude of the unmodulated carrier voltage, which is denoted by EC. And in the last, there are some advantages and disadvantages of amplitude modulation. So first of all, we study the advantages of amplitude modulation. So there are separate advantages of amplitude modulation, and some of these reasons have meant that it is still in widespread use today. The number one is it is simple to implement, which means that it is not complicated at all. It is very simple to implement. And number two is it can be demodulated using a circuit consisting of very few components, and AM receivers are very cheap as no specialized components are needed. And here are some disadvantages of amplitude modulation. So amplitude modulation is a very basic form of modulation, as we know that, and although its simplicity is one of its major advantages, because it is not complicated, so its advantage is it is very simple to implement. So other more sophisticated systems provide a number of advantages. Accordingly, it is worth looking at some of the disadvantages of amplitude modulation. So number one is it is not efficient in terms of its power uses. It also not efficient in terms of its use of bandwidth, because requiring a bandwidth equal to twice that of the highest audio frequency. And it is prone to high levels of noise, because most noise